Hello again, everybody. It's Scott Casper. Takedown Media. Our coverage of the sport continues. Today, we head to Sacramento, California. The Nike Hot Seat special guest there is August Wesley. August, good morning, Coach. How are you?
Good morning, Scott. I'm doing well.
It's been a while since we caught up, but today, perhaps, deservedly so, an opportunity to go one-on-one with you. I want to talk to you a little bit about the Iowa State Wrestling Club, which you're shepherding into an incredible Great Plains Conference Championship. It was one that had me scratching my head because the point said you won, but they announced you as a third-place finisher, and that kind of came as a shock to you, didn't it?
It did. It was interesting. They had just tried the new program with Flow Wrestling, and so the NCAA adopted that program. So midway through the year, some of the coaches were still dealing with glitches, and somehow at the end of the day, it had us down as the number three team. Wayne State out of Nebraska was the number one team with a 30-point lead. Second place was the Air Force Academy prep team. It put us in third, and Colorado State in fourth, and Winona State and University of Colorado and the rest of the 10 teams underneath. But it was a head scratcher for us. And the Air Force coach and I sat down and looked that we both had, you know, 6 and 7 wrestlers in the finals, and we both had multiple champions. And we couldn't really figure out how the math went down like that. So they actually handed out the first place team award and took pictures before we were able to, redo the math and declare us as the champions.
This happens, human error, computer error. The fact is, yeah, you had 6 medalists and 3 champs. Okay, something was definitely wrong. Wayne State initially announced as the winners, only had 5 place winners and really no chance. So there was something wrong. You guys got together, reviewed the scoring and the points, and then you went to the hotel. So you filed your concern, you went to the hotel, and it was at the hotel. You got a phone call there. Talk to us about that call.
Yeah, I got the text message saying that I should return back to the wrestling location, and that they had redid the scoring bracket by bracket, you know, and so that's 11 brackets for us in the NCAA. And so they called the Air Force Academy coach as well. And so I walked back across the street and I came in and they handed me a new list of in order. And they said that there had been a mistake and that this was the new order of participants. And so it had us, they said Iowa State, your number one with 72.5 points, and with 70 points it was the Air Force Academy, and underneath them was Wayne State and then Colorado State. So I was I felt good the fact that the kids put in that work, but it was a little frustrating because we didn't have the opportunity to celebrate amongst our peers and to get cheered on by our whole conference, being the conference champions of 2017. As anybody would feel a little cheated in that process. Not that I blame anyone for it, but it was tough. But
it's an interesting event to have happened to a club that really only had, you know, a few people showing up on a regular basis to practice and then compete. But now you've got some 45 to 50 kids showing up on a regular basis wanting to compete. Now, remember, this is the club team. This is not Iowa State Cyclone Wrestling Division I program where your son Anthony is going to be wrestling at 141 or 149. This is a club team, and it operates in such a way, folks, that the budget for this club team comes out of student activity funds. There are other clubs, there's volleyball, et cetera, where kids are able to compete, but not at the Division I level. Many of these kids that are on this team that you're coaching, August, have had a lot of experience at high school, and many of them a lot of success at the high school level. So it's a way to continue their wrestling career.
Correct. Yeah. You know, we have a broad variety of student athletes on our club team. We have some people that have never wrestled a day in their life and was interested in the sport due to, you know, notoriety, due to being at Iowa State, due to MMA stuff that they see on TV. and they want to come try it out and see how it is. And then we have guys that are multiple state placers. We have guys that have placed in regionals, placed there in Iowa. So there's a big gap in the talent level that we have. But the fact is that they are at Iowa State. Iowa is a wrestling state. And for all intents and purposes, one of the best states in the country in producing top tier athletics. So when you have these athletes that come in the room, they know there's going to be a bit of competitiveness in that room.
Iowa State's wrestling club, as I mentioned, let's talk about it 2 years ago. It's been transformed. The whole club has been transformed into one of the best club programs in the country. As a matter of fact, 13 duels this year, the entire year inside the top five, including a three-month stretch at number one. You've got to be awfully proud of club president Tyler Cutts and the boys because they've brought this energy back. Where are you guys practicing at?
We have our own practice facility there at Iowa State. We practice in State Gym. There's two gyms on campus. One is called Lead. That's closer to the stadium. And then we have State Gym. That's just a little bit further back, closer to the bookstore. But it's a beautiful facility, swimming pool, sauna room, weightlifting, cardio, walk, climbing wall. It's new. That facility is great. So we have our own wrestling mat. We have our own, like I said, our own facility. We're right next to boxing. We have a boxing club that's pretty good there too. So you got to walk past boxing to get to ours, but it's pretty exciting to have our own facility and not really to have to share it with anybody. We have other clubs that use it. You know, MMA club comes in and uses the room as well. Judo club comes in and uses the room, but we have allocated times throughout the week. We practice Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturdays if needed. When we're not in competition mode, we have Saturday practices as well. So it's just a great opportunity for us to have our own facility like that.
August Wesley, our guest, he's the head coach of the Iowa State Club Wrestling Program and doing quite well. He has another job, and that's Indercombe High School in Sacramento, California. That's where he's teaching and coaching. And you've had an exceedingly great list of accomplishments as well, Coach. And you've been Coach of the Year. You've been NCAA West Coast Conference Coach of the Year, Sacramento State University Coach of the Year. We can go back to your own competition. You know, I didn't get to see you wrestle in Finland with the Masters World Team because you had an injury which prohibited you from doing so. Can you talk to us about where you're at on that injury?
Oh, I'm fine. I'm 100% back. I had a heel injury right in July, which was a tough time for me to get that. And I trained, you know, very diligently. I watched my weight. I was on the mat. I trained with my son and others. Now that my son is older and bigger, he's a lot more formidable than he was when he was just a little buckaroo running around. But now that he's 5'8 and 165 pounds, I can train with him. And the fact that he has so much national experience and has been in these kinds of competitions, we can work our way through some positions, which can be helpful to me and him. So that injury was just was really devastating to me because I was ready to retire from competition, you know, at that particular time in my life, and just go ahead and just coach. But to get an injury, sometimes as an athlete, you feel like your body let you down or you wasn't completely prepared for every situation. And so after getting through that injury and now back to where I am, I'm going to compete probably one last time coming up here in Bulgaria at the Masters World Championships coming up in October.
I love it. By the way, I've got to ask you about our boy Shep Jones, assistant coach. He's still with you, isn't he?
He is. Shep does a great job for us. He's a little bit bigger than me. He's a heavyweight, but Shep and I work out and train, you know, often. He has been my assistant coach there at Indercombe High School for all 5 years. As a matter of fact, you know, had he not signed on to coach with me, I wasn't going to take the job. Wow. I really respect him and what he brings to the program. Him coming from the California Jets, which is an awesome club team. You know, Dan Henderson and others came out of there. Heath Sims, just many good athletes came out of, Olympians came out of that club, and he was in there. So just what he brings to the table as our head girls coach and as our primary heavyweight coach is just fabulous. And, you know, we talk daily. I'll see him tonight.
Well, tell him we send our best, Coach Shep Jones, assistant coach. All right, so let's get back to Iowa State D1 wrestling, where your son was recruited, and then on top of that, he gets the invite, accepts the invitation by Kevin Jackson. But now Kevin Jackson leaves, and Kevin Dresser assumes the role of head coach there at the university. And I must ask you, what are the thoughts from your son's perspective of the coaching change?
I can tell you he's excited. I mean, it was a difficult time. That's a position, you know, there's a business of coaching, you know, either at the professional level, at the NFL or NBA, and even at the college level. And it's a process that's over our pay grade. You know, we don't make those decisions, but he signed on to wrestle for Kevin Jackson and the Iowa State Cyclones, and did so diligently in his redshirt year and this year in his competitive year, you know, winning over 15 matches and placing in multiple tournaments and even competing this year at the National Collegiate Open there in Delaware. But when they decided to make a change and the leadership there at the school, we had to take a long, hard look at the whole reason for him to go to Iowa State. And we absolutely love Kevin Jackson, what he brings to the table as an Olympic and world medalist, what he brings to the table as far as a development standpoint, working with the whole student athlete. You know, he spent a lot of time with my son on holidays, a lot of times mentoring him and bringing him along. And not just my son, other kids in the program. I got to see firsthand that he definitely is a hands-on coach. That said, when they made the decision to go in a different direction, we had to sit down and take a hard look at the fact that why you're there and what Iowa State brings to the table outside of Coach Jackson. And Iowa State is a wonderful campus with a great student leadership. Their academics are second to not many. You know, they're very good academically, and my son was doing very well academically. He's in student leadership programs. He was just accepted into a marketing mentorship for the summer. So he really liked where he was. And then, like everybody else, we did a little research on Kevin Dresser and the fact that he has been so successful at Virginia Tech and multiple high schools around the country. His staff that he brought, now that we know the complete staff that he had brought with him, is great. You got a St. John who's a national All-American and multiple-time finalist. You got a Zadik, who the Zadik family, as we know, is fabulous in the sport of wrestling. His brother's at the Olympic Training Center. Mike has wrestled diligently, being in the Big Ten Finals multiple times and placing at the NCAAs. And you got a Brent Metcalf, who was a stud in high school and even at the college level, three-time NCAA All-American, and had just left his job at the Olympic Training Center to come here. So he essentially put together an all-star staff, and everybody signed on to it. There's a huge amount of excitement in Ames for the new coaching staff, not taking anything away from the past coaching staff because they did a great job over 7 years. But my son is excited about the opportunity and loves it there in Ames. He's treated well, and that community reaches out to all their student athletes, but particularly wrestling. There's pictures up on the wall, even the same one that I have right here. You could find that up in the mall. You can see those things up around. Everybody knows who the wrestlers are in the community. You go into Target or Walmart or a restaurant, you'll see those up. And so people just really reach out. It's a great community, and he's happy to be there.
Oh, I got to believe that. Well, Anthony, we're looking forward to seeing what he's doing over the summer. And then again, as we approach the fall, it's always good to catch up with you, August. And you've got so much going on. But what you give back in terms of time to the kids, you, Jim Hall, Curtis Chapman, Shep Jones, Peggy Chapman, Brandy Hall, Jamar Wallace.
Wallace.
Yeah. I mean, am I missing anybody?
You know, I can tell you at Ingercombe High School, we have a great staff over there, and it has worked really well for me. As you know, the last time we talked, I wasn't part of a high school program at that time. I had my club team, and I was pretty happy with that. I was content with those student athletes that we had that was competing in the national championships and going to Pocatello, Idaho, and getting accepted into the Olympic Training Center as 2016 future Olympians. And then I got a call to be part of a high school program. And I wasn't quite sure that I wanted to step back into the high school role. It's difficult. You know, you deal with parents a lot more. You deal with kids that you're still trying to guide and mold. And so I accepted the challenge. Our athletic director, Matt Hinton, is a fabulous support system. He understood what I was bringing to the table as a college coach and as a past high school coach, and really gave me the latitude to build the program, which had not been successful in the first 7 years of existence. They hadn't won a league championship. They hadn't won a conference title. They hadn't had but one state qualifier, never a state medalist, never a master's champion or finalist. So there was a lot of opening for us to be successful. So I put together a staff, including Curtis Chapman and Shep Jones, and we built from those two people into a fabulous program that we have. Now we've won 3 consecutive conference championships. We just won the section title. We are the first section champion in any sport for our school. Wow. At Ingercombe High School. So there's a lot of excitement around that. We have over 45 kids with over a 3.0 GPA, mandatory study hall and such. So our staff has grown definitely to meet the needs of our students. We have female wrestlers as well. A state medalist this year in Alex Ceballos. She placed 5th in the state this year. Nemo Chapman placed 5th in the state for us on the boys' side at 195 pounds. So it's just been a fabulous experience for me at Ingercombe.
You're getting it done at Ingercombe and in Ames, Iowa, even from afar, putting that program together. Our best to your family, everybody around the program. Great talking with you. Great catching up, August. We will do it again sooner than later. How about that?
That sounds great, Scott. Thank you for the opportunity.
August Wesley, our guest in the Nike Hot Seat today, Sacramento, California. Wrestling is alive and well and growing in the Sunshine State. I'm Scott Casper. Thanks for watching this very special edition of the Nike Hot Seat with our guest, August Wesley.